Alice worked as a nurse in England, and her boys were born in England. Although they, I believe they only came to live back to live in Jersey when they were 2 years old, 3 years old. But when Hitler personally put an order out that all English-born residents of Jersey were going to be deported to camps in Germany, obviously Clem and my father Frank had to go. Now at that time, Clem, the oldest boy, was 18 and my father was 17. So you can just imagine the horrendous effects that that would have had on not just Clem and Frank, but also, you know, Alice and all of the family. And of course it wasn't just them, it was the whole island. His timing couldn't have been worse. Apparently he loved gymnastics. He got very, very badly injured in a gymnasium accident in Jersey 2 weeks before the deportation order came. He ripped all his muscles in his groin and upper leg area. So he could hardly walk, actually. He was in a really bad way. And then that order came that him and his brother Clem had to be deported. With the help of the International Red Cross and with his brother's help, Clem, they helped him to write a letter in German to the German camp commandant at Laufen, basically pleading that he was no danger to the German people, that he'd be sent back to his island where his mother, as a nurse, could nurse him and his sister too and bring him back to health. Believe it or not, the Germans agreed. And so they agreed that he could be sent back to Jersey. He was put into the custody of a young German soldier. When I say young, apparently, according to my grandmother, he was about 19 years old. And his orders were to escort my father, Frank, through occupied Europe back to Jersey and deliver him personally to Birchall Green Streets in Hallier to my grandmother. That trip was particularly harrowing, my father's told me, because the German soldier, of course, had to use German army transport, troop transports. He had to sleep in barracks. The whole of Europe was occupied by Germany at that time. And as soon as the soldiers found out that this was an Englishman who was being escorted back, they basically wanted to kill him. So this young German soldier wasn't just the escort, he was a protector. But eventually they made it back to Jersey, and in the diary you can read Alice's reaction when she heard a knock on the door one night, opened the door, and there at the door was a thin, sick Frank, her son, with a German soldier. So you can imagine the joy that she felt.